Yes, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
Thank you, Lord. Jeremiah chapter 33. From verse 1 to 3. Hallelujah. Jeremiah chapter 33. The Bible says, and the word of the Lord came to Jeremiah a second time, while he was still shut up in the court of the guard. That says the Lord who made the earth, and the Lord who formed it to establish it. The Lord is his name. Call to me, and I will answer you.
Yeah.
And will tell you great and hidden things that you have not known. Call to me, and I will answer you.
Amen.
And will tell you great and hidden things that you have not known. And Jesus said, man does not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes from the mouth of God.
Amen.
Call to me, I will answer you, and will tell you of great and hidden things that you have not known.
Amen.
And we go to the scripture of our revival, Matthew chapter 5, verse 1 to 11. You can read it in your own time. Hallelujah.
Look.
From verse 1 to 11. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The theme of this revival is cast your net. Amen.
Amen.
Cast your net into the deep. Amen.
Amen.
In the book of Luke chapter 5, 1 to 11, when Jesus approached Simon Peter and his crew, it's already been said by previous speakers that these guys were experienced fishermen. They were doing their day-to-day activity. But now they were toiling. It's one thing to be in a temporary situation.
Yeah.
But now when it becomes a lifestyle, then now it's a problem.
Right.
It's one thing for me not to have money.
Yeah.
But now when it becomes a situation that all the time, that now I'm now toiling, then it's a problem. It's okay for me to be sick for a while. Because sickness allows God to reveal himself as a healer. But now, if it becomes a thing that I now identify with, that when a headache comes to me, I'm now used to it, then it's a problem. Help me, Holy Ghost. Help me. Help me, Holy Ghost. Help me, Holy Ghost. These people, they were used to their jobs. They were used to their day-to-day activities. They were fishing as usual. And on this day now, they were now used to being tired. But on this particular day, they met Jesus. Jesus did not Jesus did not ask them to meet them where he is. But Jesus went to where they are. Many people tell you that you have to come to God. But the Bible shows me in a few scriptures that sometimes Jesus comes to you. Hear me, hear me, hear me, hear me.
Come on now.
Sometimes you can go through life situations that you no longer know how to pray. You know the words. You know the scriptures. But you have lost strength. You don't know how to find your way. Sometimes you can be in a time. People say worship. I don't know. I want to worship. But I'm in the dark. I'm here today, today. If that's you, Jesus is coming to your postcode tonight.
Glory! Glory!
I've lived long enough to know I can come in church. I lift my hands. Nothing happened.
Jesus to visit me where I am.
Glory be to Jesus.
Begin to open up your heart. Begin to open up your heart. Begin to open up your heart. You can come to church your whole life. Maybe these guys were coming Sunday to Sunday, toiling, doing the things you are used to do. And you are being told, now pray. But now Peter, it's the same thing he says. Lord, I've prayed for a very long time. Lord, I've fasted for a very long time. Lord, I've been singing for a very long time. I'm now tired because it's not producing results. But Jesus, when he came to them, he says to Peter, try again, just one more time. Help me, investigator. Shakarabasa.
Thank you, Jesus. Talk to us now. Glory.
If you read the Bible, Jesus was not there past to meeting Peter. Jesus actually met them at that time. You don't only meet God when you see him manifest. When you were going through in the dark, Jesus was still there. Jesus knew it wasn't an accident that he happened to be at the same place. Sometimes you don't know how to go to God because I'm drowned in so much alcohol. I'm drowned in so much fornication. The church tells me I need to repent, but I don't know which sin because I try to repent about my drinking. My fornication kicks in to say you're still a liar. But when Jesus comes, there is a second chance.
Thank you, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Oh, my way. Help us, Jesus. Help us, Jesus. Shakarabasatama. When he met Peter, Peter was honest enough. Because when God comes to you, it's now up to the recipient for you to open up. Because if you see now, when he came to Peter, the Bible says that when he casted the net, they caught so many fish. Other people were attracted by the fish. But Peter knew it says that I've had fish before. I've been satisfied before. I've had money before. I'm not seeking you for money. I'm not seeking you for a husband. I'm not seeking you for a job. Because I've had a job before. But I really want something that is beyond. Other people are satisfied by the blessings of God. But if you have toiled for a long time, money means nothing to you. Is it Jesus? And say, Jesus, I got the issues of my heart. I don't mind. I don't mind about money. I'll work for money. I don't mind about a job. I'm willing to go on benefits. But in this moment, I want something more than the fish I used to have. That the fish I'm used to. Holy Ghost. Listen, if you're here for money tonight, this is not your night. If you're here for a husband, this is not your night. Today is for people who are hungry for Jesus. It's for people who are saying, I'm tired of being in the dark. Let them judge me. But I know Jesus works from the inside out. I might still drink a little bit, but I know it's only a matter of time before the Jesus on the inside make an adjustment that I will no longer be a slave to a no longer toil. I will no longer rely on people.
Thank you, Jesus.
Come on, Jesus. Yes, come on, Jesus. Yes.
Our God is bigger. This God is bigger. This God is bigger. He's bigger than a Sunday service. He's bigger than just worship. He's bigger than a preacher. He's bigger than the all-night prayer. He's bigger than that Bible there. That Bible is just a little CV of what God can do. There is a scripture that says, if the Bible was to record everything that Jesus did, there is not enough paper on earth to contain it. I'm telling you, God is bigger. God is bigger than what you know. God is bigger than your revelation. God is bigger than your presence, than your experience in your closet. God is bigger than the goose from years before. No human has the capacity to contain God. No human, all we know is a fraction in a lifetime. Then we pass by and by. You can never finish God. If you are tired of coming to church and going back home the same, it's because you have now begun to limit God. But I'm here to say that Jesus is bigger than what we know. Jesus is bigger than what I can preach. I don't know what you desire tonight, but I'm here to say Jesus is here. The disciples, they were toiling all night. I know that the power is not in the method, but the power is in who's behind you. The power isn't in your money, but the power is who that money came from. The power isn't in you eating well, but the power is in who sustains you well. Hear me, hear me, hear me. The power is not in your efforts, but the power is who's got your back. Because sometimes when people are telling you not to go places, if God speaks to you, you have to step in boldness, because we are used to look around. If you notice in the scripture there, Peter was the only one who realized. The Bible says he was with two people, but Peter was the only person who realized to say that I know what brought the fish. Wasn't because this guy was timing, but he is the keeper of the fish. Yes. Whatever I desire, he is the one who can give me.
Thank you, Lord.
We testify about our marriages. We testify about our jobs. But God is bigger than that. Don't limit God by coming to church seeking for things you can work for. I don't want God for money. I can study and work for money. I don't want God to be smart. I can study, I can spend my mind and do that. But now, there is a peace that the money cannot give me. There is a peace. You can be in a relationship and be lonely. Now that's the realm that God operates. You can have friends and be lonely. I've been there. You can be in church and not be in church. Now that's the realm of God. Money can buy you your house you are looking for. If you want a house, work. If you want a car, work. But now, God is more than what we are using him for.
Yes.
Thank you, Lord.
Even a headache, all I have to do is drink paracetamol.
Yeah.
I'm not going to limit God to healing.
Yes.
God is bigger.
Yes.
God is bigger.
Yes.
God is bigger.
Yes.
Tonight we want to pray.
Yes.
Tonight we want to pray. I don't know. I don't know. I want you to cast your net to a place where you have never said, saying, God, my times now limit you. Because I can say, Ria Tepo Shataka, and think I've reached God. But there are some new times in God. Revelation, there is more in God. What we know is just a speck. What we know is just a speck. Oh, Holy Ghost. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. How many are ready? How many are ready? How many are ready? I don't worry about your time. You've spent some time upon a useless thing. You spend some time watching a movie. But when you come in the presence of God, try to give him your all. So God can deposit some peace in you. So God can deposit some spirit in you. That you can now look those demons in the place and say, you know what? In the name of Jesus, these things I don't do anymore. Because there are some things that money cannot get rid of. The Bible says the just shall live by faith, not faith in money. The just will not live by money. The just will not live by their jobs. The just will not live by their relationships. If your husband is the God you have, then you better shift your focus today that men can die. That man can die. That man can die. That wife of yours can die. They can get brain damage. Where is your God now? Our faith needs to be in Jesus. Our faith needs to be in Jesus. This is not an experiment. I know this God. I was in the dark. I know this God. I came to church. Did everything that I was supposed to do. But when I began to do it, I still felt empty and lonely. Until I said, Jesus, dear Jesus, get inside my boat. I'm willing to trade my friends for peace. I'm willing to trade my habits for you.
Yes!
Thank you, Jesus.
Yes, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Peter had the right attitude. There were three people there. Sometimes you may come to church as friends, but when God ministers to you, it's on a different level. So you can't look at your neighbor and say, maybe are they worshiping or not? These other guys, they got the revelation of Jesus later on. But on that day, Peter got it. So even where you are here tonight, some of the people you came with are not gonna realize. So if you feel it in your spirit, cast the net and drink some more. Why? Because this journey, we were born again at different stages, and we are in life, we are going through different circumstances. So when you feel a move of God in your spirit, don't look at your neighbor. Don't try to compare yourself. Don't worry about them. Because it's you that at night, you are the person who cannot sleep. Could be husband and wife. Sleeping in the same bed. One is sleeping, one not. Why? Because when it comes to these things, they are personal. Even when we will die, it's going to be personal. Heaven is not a collective effort. You don't know when your clock is going to run out. You don't know when God is going to call you. So when you come in here, you have to take it seriously.
Yes, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Yes, Jesus.
Thank you, Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. 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 For the few minutes that we have, we want to knock on the door of heaven. I'm telling you, God is bigger. God is bigger. God, did you hear this scripture? He was saying this to a prophet. He says, call to me and I will answer you and will tell you great and hidden things that you have not known. This was Jeremiah, the prophet that God visited and says, before I formed you, I knew you while you were still in your mother's womb. The same God who says, I have chosen you and appointed you and separated you. You are going to be my mouthpiece. He was validated by God. God spoke to him directly. He was the man who walked with God. But now in chapter 33, God is saying to the same man, even though you have walked with me, I know you have been used in praise and worship. I know you have been used in prophecies. I know you have been used in prayer. I know You have been used as a preacher, but here is my word tonight. Go to me, and I will answer you, and I will tell you great and hidden things you have not known. There are hidden things we don't know. There are hidden things we don't know. There are hidden things you don't know. Some of the things you are going in circles in your life because they are hidden from you. And God today is saying, come, call unto me. Call unto me. The circle you are going through in your family, you see it in your mother. You see it in your father. Call unto me. I'll show you the hidden things. I'll show you where exactly the issue is. I'll show you the cause. And I'll show you how to deal with it. Everyone, no matter how much you've walked with God, today is saying, call unto me. Call unto me. Call unto me. There is more to me than the level you're limiting me. There is more to me than the tongues you have. There is more to me than the revelation you have. Call unto me and I will answer you and tell you great and hidden things that you have not known.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Yeah. Hallelujah. Yeah. What I liked about Peter, he was humble enough. He says, Master, get away from me. I am a sinner, I don't deserve. He had an attitude of a beggar. Sometimes when we go to God, we are so entitled. We are so entitled. God, because I worship you, I deserve a cup. God, because I praise you so much, I pray and fast, God. I pray and fast, God. God help me, I worship you so much. I spend my money in church. That's our approach to God. But Peter wasn't like that. He didn't say to Jesus, since I let you in my boat, now bless me. He realized that if this man can control the fish, even the boat I have belongs to him. Let me humble myself. The husband I have belongs to you, God. The wife I have came from you, God. The job that I have came from you, God. The oxygen that I have came from you, God. Even this face I put makeup came from you, God. Peter had the right attitude. God help me today. God help me today. Help me adjust my attitude. Help me adjust my attitude in prayer. We are not casting something today. We want to adjust our attitude in prayer. Even though Jesus used Peter's boat, Peter was humble enough to say, God, I'm a sinner. I don't deserve. But Jesus, we serve a good God. I know you have things that are on your mind that are condemning you now. I know you probably did something last night. I know you only came here saying, God, I'm going to give you a chance one again. I know you promised God. The same Peter was the one who says, God, I will never deny you. But Jesus has so much love and compassionate to understand that sometimes we are like the prodigal son. That sometimes we are in our pride where we tell God, if you bless me today, I will never go back. But even when we go back, His grace is sufficient enough. I know you made a promise, God, before and saying, God, if you save me, I'm not going to sin again. But God is saying that I know that you meant it, but sometimes you are weak. When Peter told Jesus, I'll never deny you, he wasn't lying. He was saying what he felt at that time. But we serve a God who knows us beyond even our mistakes.
Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. What promises have you made to God? That now you can no longer even pray because you are afraid that God will call you upon a promise. What did you tell God? What did you promise him before? What's keeping you away from God? Isaiah chapter 1 says, come, let's reason together. Though your sins are as red as scarlet, I'll make them as white as snow. Today there is a new chapter. Today there is a fresh chapter. God is saying, forget about your past. Forget about the hurt. Forget about the promises. He's saying the same thing he says to Peter. Peter, I know you're gonna trip, but don't worry, I've prayed for you that your faith will not fail you. That when you are now stronger, you can testify and encourage other people. We want to pray today. We want to pray. You are coming to church. Part of you still feels guilty. Part of you still feel content. You promise God something. I'm not talking about what you can prophesy. Your heart is the greatest prophet. I don't need to see your heart. That secret sin in your heart that your wife doesn't know about, that your husband doesn't know about, that every time you really try to go to the next level, the devil brings it up. Tonight we want to bring those things before God. Because we serve a faithful God. He says, come. He says, come. Come as you are. Come as you are. The Bible says that God is near to the brokenhearted. God will never reject a humble spirit. Or you have to change your approach. Don't pray tonight, don't pray like you are entitled. You waking up does not depend on your prayer. Hallelujah. 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 We want to go before God. We want to go before God. I don't know how long it's going to be, but we want to pray, people of God. We want to pray, people of God. Otherwise, you continue being like the disciples. You cry, God, I keep going to church all the time. But I come home the same. I keep giving my money in church. I keep sowing a seed. I keep going for an altar call. But even when they lay hands on me, even when they put anointing oil, nothing is changing on the inside of me. That's what the disciples were saying. Lord, we have toiled all night. But tonight God is saying, try me again. Adjust your attitude. Don't come to me as entitled. Humble yourself and say, Lord, I really don't deserve. But I know you are a gracious God. Please, Lord, here is my petition. That's the prayer we're making tonight. That's the prayer we're making tonight. Find your own corner. Find your own moment. Find your own corner. I don't know. You can be a Christian and come to church. Know all the songs. Be a faithful time keeper. Be a faithful member. But on the inside, Jesus is no longer there. It's a dry well on the inside. That's what I've come to preach to you about today. That's what I've come to visit you about today. I'm not here to pray for you to get your healing. I'm here about your heart. Your heart, your spirit. God can heal you later, but first he has to touch that inner man. Otherwise, at this rate, if things go, you commit suicide. As a believer believing in Jesus, you commit suicide. You are willing to leave your family because you are restless. You are not at peace every time you come for prayer. But tonight, there is a God in heaven. There is a God in heaven. The same Jesus. The Bible says Jesus is the same yesterday, today, and forever. The same Jesus who visited Peter on his boat that day is here tonight. I'm here to help you call on him today. As he said to Jeremiah, call unto me. He says to Jeremiah, he says, oh, to me I will answer and will tell you great and hidden things. There are hidden things within us. And we want God to reveal those things tonight. Hallelujah. Let's all rise on our feet if you can. Shaka Rabasada Ramaki. Leka Rabasada Ramaki. Shaka Rabasada Ramaki.